Welcome back, baseball fans. It is the 1984, 69, 70, 71 All-Star Game live from Dodger Stadium in Chavez Ravine. The American League All-Stars at the National League All-Stars. This game brought to you by Aqua Velva, the cool, refreshing aftershave. Yes, there's something about an Aqua Velva man. And by B.F. Goodrich, tires you can trust. We're the other guys. Well, baseball fans, it's a great day. The All-Star Game is here. I hope you watch the All-Star Game selection show. I don't want to hammer it away, but it's pretty extensive, 40-minute viewing. So assuming you did all that, we're just going to get right into the game. We have, for the American League, it'll be Nolan Ryan starting for the visitors from the first-place Texas Rangers. And of course, the best pitcher in baseball, Juan Marichal, toes the slab from the San Francisco Giants here in Dodger Stadium to a smattering of applause. But yeah, Giants fans, Dodger fans, you know. Juan Marichal, Nolan Ryan, and now we'll just get right into it. Leading off for the Minnesota Twins, third baseman, Cesar Tovar. Tovar leads off the game. He rolls a 6-10 off Marichal, his third X. Third baseman is... who's starting at third base? Oh, it's Larry Parrish. Remember, he's a 4E14. And he makes the play. One out. We commented earlier that the National League infield is all fours. Dick Allen's a four at first. Jim Morrison a four at second. Larry Parrish a four at third, and Hanson a four at short. They don't care. They're going with sticks. And the first defensive play was made. So there you go. Batting second from the Minnesota Twins, Rod Carew. Carew. And the pitch to Carew. Off his car. Double one to 16 is a base hit. Carew's on first. Batting third, the left fielder, number 20 from the Baltimore Orioles, Frank Robinson. And Frank Robinson, 211, pops to second. All right, I'll get rid of the echo. I thought I would do it for a little bit and get tired of it. So, no more echo. Batting fourth from the Texas Rangers, formerly Washington Senators, the heart and soul of that team that's playing so well, Frank Howard. 1-6, Frank Howard. Let's look at his card again. It is gone, a two-run shot off of Marichal, who can't believe it. Marichal, 8-0 with a 1.54 ERA coming into the All-Star game, and Frank Howard goes yard for the American League. Give it up for the big man, all 6 foot 10 inches of him or whatever. Batting fifth, the right fielder, number 9 from the Oakland A's. And here comes the boos. They boo Reggie. Reggie Jackson, 38 on Reggie's car is ball 4. He's a beast stealer. He's not going to challenge bench. Batting sixth, the shortstop from the Boston Red Sox, Rico Petroselli. And Petroselli, 48, single to center field off of Marichal's card. Reggie with 2 outs. Does he try and go coast to coast off Willie Davis? This would be a mistake, but he's going to do it because he's Reggie. 1-16 and get the third. He gets the third. You have runners on the corners. And you've got Don Mattingly. Mattingly, the first baseman from the New York Yankees, number 23. Don Mattingly batting seventh. The pitch, 1-7 off his card, is a double to right field. The American League has got it going. Petroselli, 1-12 runner, trying to score from first. 13-14, but it's Hank Aaron. No, they cut it off. And they hold up Petroselli at third base, but we got 3 runs. With runners at second and third, and it'll be batting eighth from the Expos, their favorite player ever, Gary Carter. So Gary Carter with runners at second and third and 2 outs in the first inning, 46 off the Marichal card. What a disaster this has been. Double 1-7, that is a double. And that'll score two more runs for the American League, 5 runs. Wow, 5 runs in the first inning off Marichal with a runner at second and two outs. The final batter, and then I'll hook him. I won't embarrass him anymore. Bobby Mercer, the center fielder. 32 is a foul out the catcher. And the first inning is finally over, but not before the American League, who didn't win a lot of these All-Star games, goes up incredibly 5-0. Wow. So we'll get Nolan Ryan toes the slab here now with a 5-run lead. Leading off for the National League, their center fielder, Willie Davis, from the hometown Dodgers, and the Dodger fans go nuts, as he is the only left-handed bat in the batting order. And he leads it off for the Dodgers. The pitch, 58, is a strikeout off the Ryan card. Batting second, the first baseman from the Philadelphia Phillies. He bats second because he has a high on-base percentage and doesn't hit any double plays because he struck out 144 times. Dick Allen, virtually no double play threat. Dick Allen batting second, 38 is a strikeout. And with two outs, batting third, number 44 from the Atlanta Braves in right field, the leading hitter in the National League at the break, Henry Aaron. And the pitch to Aaron is a sky to left field. We'll go to the second, and we're pulling Marichal. Yeah, you don't let him go back out. What if it happens again, right? All right, so Rick Rodin will come in a little earlier than expected in the second inning. And it'll be the top of the American League lineup again. Tovar, 3-6, Tovar, single 111, is a base hit. He's a double-A stealer. He got benched, -4 catcher. But it's the All-Star game, and you got a 5-run lead. You got to try it, right? He's going to steal off a bench. And he steals off of Johnny Bench, runner at second for Rod Carew. Carew, 2-4, skies to right. Frank Robinson, 43, flies it into left field. And the left fielder, I don't have macros for positions, left field, Jack Clark's a 2-e-3 in left field. A 2, and he makes the catch. So the runner at second and two outs, it's Frank Howard again. 37's a walk. Two on, two outs. Reggie Jackson. 1-8 is a strikeout. And Roden gets out of it. All right. Bottom of two. Ryan's going to stick around for one more inning, as the starters normally do. Johnny Bench. 48. Double 1-10. That's a base hit. Off of the Ryan card. Batting fifth, the left fielder from the Giants. The only offensive player to make the All-Star game in a surprise is Willie McCovey was left off the team. Jack Clark, runner at first. Jack Clark, 212, short B, fielder's choice. Batting sixth, the third baseman, leading RBI guy for the National League, Larry Parrish from the Houston Astros. Runner at first and one out, Larry Parrish. 1-4, flies to left field. Batting seventh. And here are the Colorado Rockies get some not-so-Hall of Fame players into the All-Star game because they are the number one seed in the National League. And here's one of them, journeyman second baseman Jim Morrison, but having a great first half and got a good, well-deserved All-Star start. Jim Morrison, 58, that's a strikeout off the Ryan card. And we are through two here in L.A., and it's 5-0 American League. Let's see, since Marichal was pulled early, we're going to give Roden, who led the National League starters in ERA with 104, we'll let him go another inning here. Petrucelli, 2-6 off the Petrucelli card. Let's check it out again. 1-14, it's gone. 6-0, American League. Wow. Mattingly, 6-10, bounces a short. This is Hanson. And he's a 4-e-14 at short, and that's a base hit. We know the National League has no defense in the infield, but they weren't supposed to be down 6-0 either. They have no help today. Gary Carter, 57 is a K. Bobby Mercer, 59, second C. Runner at second, two outs. And it's Tovar for the third, and we'll play more than that. 67, single 1-10 off the Roden card. He lines out. So Roden gives up a solo shot. Ryan's going to go a third inning with a big 6-0 lead. He runs into any trouble, we're not going to embarrass him. Brant Aliyea is their number 8 hitter and designated hitter from the Colorado Rockies. He actually played 258 at-bats for the Minnesota Twins in 1970 to create this card. He got taken in the expansion draft. So this is why Brant Aliyea is participating today. The pitch, 38, is a bouncer to short. Batting ninth, and your surprise shortstop start. He can play anywhere in the infield, nowhere particularly well, but he's having a great first half with power and on base. Ron Hansen. Ron Hansen's your batter. 49, triple 1-4. That's a triple off the Ryan card. Now, second time around, and I got Willie Davis and Murderers Row after that. But I got a 6-0 lead. We have to leave Ryan in a little longer. Plus, he's good against lefties. Willie Davis, 1-6, is a ground ball to short. And they just let that run score. They didn't try to bring the infield up with a big lead. So they give the National League that run. And Dick Allen, 3-6, is a walk. And it's Hank Aaron, Nolan Ryan here. This is a big at-bat. We don't want to taint Ryan's All-Star start if we don't have to. Hank Aaron. 1-7, Hank Aaron. Wait a minute here. Yeah, Richie Allen's held on at first base. That's a single through the hole. And you've got runners on the corners with two outs, and it's Johnny Bench. And still Nolan Ryan. There's still no movement. By the Blues ready. He's been ready. But Ryan's going to pitch one more batter. Johnny Bench, runners on the corners and two outs. The pitch to Johnny Bench. 37 off the bench card, triple 1-2, single dot dot, and that'll do it. We tried to be nice, we couldn't do it. They don't want to risk it. They get the big 6-2 lead. They want to win this All-Star game. So Vita Blue will come in the middle of the inning, in the third inning, and he will face the number 5 hitter, which is Jack Clark, with runners on the corners. Jack Clark, the pitch to Clark, 66, is a strikeout. Nolan Ryan gets out of the inning. Excuse me, Vita Blue gets out of the inning. Okay, we move to the fourth inning. It's 6-2 American League. And the Mets will bring Jerry Kuzman in. Jerry Kuzman comes trotting out of the bullpen for the National League. Carew is the batter. We might play the whole game, too. Boy, they don't have a lot of infielders on the bench, do they? They have first basemen, DHs. Ugh. Yeah, just Schofield. I think Carew and Tovar might play the whole damn game. Rod Carew, 48, bounces to second. And Jim Morrison at second base is a 4-E-14 at second. And that is an error. Carew is not much of a base stealer this particular year. Frank Robinson. 2-7. Frank Robinson, that is a 6-4-3 double play on a plus. If Carew was a base stealer this year, that would have been a single. So, real bad break for the American League. Maybe the momentum has changed. And here's Frank Howard. 5-12. Bounces it to second. Another single off of Morrison. The National League defense is playing predictably terrible now. It's Reggie Jackson. Runner at first and two outs. Reggie Jackson, 1-7 is a strikeout. We go to the bottom of the fourth, and Blue will stick around. Larry Parrish, 2-6, short. Jim Morrison, 1-8 off the Morrison card. Homer, 1-18, it's gone. Jim Morrison, wow. 6-3, they're getting nervous. The American Leaguers are getting nervous here. 6-3, wild All-Star game. Brant Aliyea, 36 is a walk. Ron Hansen, 6-10 off the blue card, short X. Petrocelli's a 2-E-16 at short. He's a 2-E-14, an error on Petrocelli. You got two on and one out for Willie Davis. The hometown Dodger fans go nuts. He represents the tie run. Willie Davis, 2-6 is a double to right field. Hansen will not try and run. So we have the tying runs are at second and third. Still just one out for Dick Allen. The pitch from Blue, 39, ball 4. It's all falling apart for the American League in the fourth inning. The bases are loaded, one out. Hank Aaron, Vita Blue, the pitch. 45, double on a 4, two-run single, and they've come all the way back. The National League has tied the game. With runners on the corners in the fourth inning. Gosh, this is terrible. I don't know what to do with Blue here. He's only gotten two outs so far. He's got the jitters, clearly. They're going to play it up for Bench with runners on the corners here in a 6-6 game. Johnny Bench, 2-11. Short B cuts him down at the plate. First and second, two outs. Final batter. I'll pull him regardless. This is his final batter, Jack Clark. And 2-8 is ball four. That'll do it. That only loads the bases, though. So he got pitched an inning, believe it or not. He started with Clark and finished with Clark. And then during that time, he retired three batters. So, for the American League, not the best spot for Denny McClain to come in. But Denny McClain comes in the fourth inning to face Larry Parrish, the leading RBI guy in the National League, with the bases loaded and two outs. 6-6 game. Larry Parrish, the pitch. 1-9. Larry Parrish shoots a screamer into deep center field. Over Mercer's head. One run scores. Two run scores. Clark has wheels. No, he doesn't. He's a 13, 14, 15. Nope, he's going to hold at third. That guy scores. That guy scores. Clark and Parrish are on the bases. No decision for Ryan. This would be a loss for Blue and a win for Roden if it stands. Jim Morrison, second and third, two outs. He homered to start this inning. Jim Morrison, 3-10, flies to left. The disaster is over. American League had a 5-run first inning. National League have a 6-run fourth inning, and they take an 8-6 lead into the fifth. Excuse me, Jerry Kuzman, I believe, right? Right, Jerry Kuzman's your pitcher record. I forgot about that. He came in and pitched the fourth inning. So, Kuzma's going to stick around. This thing's wild. And it's going to be Rico Petrocelli. He had a big error in that inning. 1-4, sky's the center. The benches have not been needed because the starters are just crushing the ball. Mattingly, 2-9, bounces the third. And with two outs, Gary Carter. 1-11, bounces to short. Kuzman gets his two innings in. He qualifies for the win. McClain will pitch the bottom of the fifth. Aiyah. He'll get one more bat. 52, right? He's a DH anyway. Ron Hansen, he'll get one more bat at short. Do they have a backup shortstop? They don't have one. 5-11, pitcher X, Denny McClain's an E8. A base hit off of McClain with one out. Willie Davis is fourth at bat in center field. We'll pull him after this at bat. 1-10, pitcher A, inning-ending double play. That's Shane. He'll leave the game for Chet Lemon to play center field as we start getting into the reserves. We're in a sixth inning. Bobby Mercer, he's the only pure center fielder on the roster. We need a new pitcher, though. So McClain ends up going an inning and a third. As the fifth inning is done, John Denny will be the pitcher in the sixth inning for the National League. John Denny comes on in the sixth inning with a two-run lead, and it's Bobby Mercer, his third at bat. 4-10, Mercer skies it in the center. That's Chet Lemon, the guy I just brought in. He's a 1-E-2 in center field. That would have been a double off Willie Davis, but we brought in Chet Lemon, and he catches the ball. American League is snake bit here, suddenly. Oh my God, they're gonna blow a 6-0 lead. Tovar, his fourth at bat. I don't see another third baseman. Well, Schofield. You know, Schofield could play third base. But we'll let Tovar get one more bat. 64, Tovar, homer 1-15. It is gone off the Denny card. Cesar Tovar, it's 8-7. So it brings Carew up in an 8-7 game. Rod Carew, 1-3, flies to right. And with two outs. Frank Robinson, his final at-bat in left field for today. 39 is a walk. And we'll let Willie Horton play left field the rest of the way. And Frank Howard, big bad Frank Howard, is yet to be retired. 2-4, he skies the center. Alright, bring in old Harold Bain. Oh, bring in his teammate Epstein for him to play DH the rest of the way. Alright, new pitcher for the American League in the sixth inning will be Jim Rooker. Jim Rooker will be the new pitcher in the sixth inning. And for the National League, Dick Allen. Oh, you want him to hit? You want him to face left-handed? So with an 8-7 lead, Rooker to Dick Allen. 36 is a walk. And they're going to have Wes Parker take over for him at first base. And the American League, National League starts to improve their defense. Henry Aaron, one more bat for him. 112. Henry Aaron's hit by the pitch. So he actually is being taken out. Feeling a little gimpy there. And Claude Washington will play right field for him. All right, Johnny Bench. He's 2-for-3. Two on in an 8-7 game. Johnny Bench against a lefty. Jeez, Rooker, do you really want to do this? Rooker, here, the pitch, 65. He walks Bench. They're loaded. Torrey will fill in for the rest of the game for Johnny Bench. More than capable of doing that. And now you've got Jack Clark. Yeah. He might play the whole game in left field since he's a Giant. 2-11. 5-4-3 double play. They played it back. They got the run. Runner goes to third with two outs and the double play ball. They'll take that. And it'll be Larry Parrish with a runner at third and two outs off Rooker. 2-3, skies the center field, but it's 9-7. All right, we get to the final three frames. John Denny will leave. He pitches an inning. Denny LeMaster, a left-hander, will come on in the seventh. Two-run lead, nine outs to go. Reggie Jackson against the lefty. Ooh, what has Reggie done today? He's a walk, couple strikeouts. You know, they're going to go with... The new right fielder is Sixto Lezcano, the leading RBI guy in the American League and a right-handed batter. Lezcano will come on to bat off for Reggie in the eighth inning. And Lezcano, 66, double 1-3. That's a double off of the LeMaster card. Petrocelli is going to play the entire game at shortstop. He's the tie run. Petrocelli, 58, skies to left. Dominantly against a left-hander. Don't we have another... Oh, we have all left-handed first base when we got... Yep, Francona and Epstein's DH-ing. But Mattingly crushes left-handed pitching, so hold back. Runner at second, one out. Mattingly, 2-11, pops the first. And with two outs, Gary Carter's final at-bat, then we'll switch it over to Tony Pena. 54, he skies in a deep center field, but that's Chet Lemon who makes the play. LeMaster survives the inning. He lets the runner get to second, but no more damage. All right, Rooker leaves. Seems like every pitcher in the American League has given up at least a run today. So, the American League will go with Ken Sanders. The Milwaukee closer will come on in the seventh inning, try and get a zero up there in a 9-7 game. Jim Morrison, he'll actually come out. And Glenn Beckert, who started the 1971 All-Star Game, the Cubs representative will bat for him. Glenn Beckert is your hitter here. Glenn Beckert leading off the inning. He strikes out. Brent Alea, the DH, he'll come out. And they'll go with Jeff Stone to be the new DH. Speedy Jeff Stone, left-handed batter. Jeff Stone is up. And Stone, 1-8, is a base hit. All right, you got speed and arm. Tony Pena, the catcher for the American League now, has a -2 arm. -3 arm. Stone's going to steal anyway with the lead. the steal. He's out on a 20. Out stealing. Two outs. Tony Pena does the job. And batting ninth, again, the shortstop. There's no other shortstops in the National League. Ron Anson. 1-9. Bounce of the short. All right, we got a 9-7 game in the eighth inning. LeMaster did his job. Now we have situational righty-lefty closer guys to get the final six outs for the National League. We'll start with Camacho in the eighth. Ernie Macho Camacho in the eighth will face Bobby Mercer. 37, ball four. And the American League will send the tie run to the plate. Tovar will leave. We'll go with switch hitting middle infielder. He can actually play. He's just like Tovar, really. He can play third short. Dick Schofield will bat. He's the tie run. And do they actually say, you know, forget it and take Camacho out and go with lefty-lefty through to Epstein here with Lefferts? Nah, I gotta leave him in there. Dick Schofield is the batter. 2-5 is hit by the pitch. Two men on for the American League. And it's Rod Carew. Now, do you want to make Camacho the sitting duck here? No, you don't want to do that. He's coming out. Sorry, Ernie. Two walks. A little shaky there. And unfortunately, the National League is turning new. The worst team in the National League in the eighth inning. Craig Deff Lefferts will pitch to Carew, Horton, and Mike Epstein. Two out of three are left-handed. They got to bring... No, it's first and second. And it's Rod Carew. Here we go. Oh, we got to put RC here under Lefferts' line. So I know who he pitches to. He pitches to Carew. Carew, 3-10 against the lefty, is single dot dot. That'll score Mercer. Schofield goes to third as the tie run, and Carew is the lead run. Oh, it's getting ugly here. 9-8. Nobody out in the eighth inning. Willie Horton. Here's a who from the World Championship Tigers. Willie Horton. The pitch to Horton. 1-7, he strikes out. He just misses it. Willie Horton just missed that one. Wow. And with two outs, it'll be Mike Epstein. Mike Epstein coming in. 8 home runs for the Texas Rangers with runners on the corners and one out in the eighth inning. Mike Epstein, 59, second C. Runners with the infield up, moves to second base. You've got second and third. You have two outs. And it'll be Sixto Lescano who doubled in his last at bat. Boy, he could be the All-Star Game MVP and not come into the game until the seventh inning. Second and third. And they're going to do situational again. They're going to go right-handed. Ron Reed, the right-hander, will face Lescano. With two on and two outs in the eighth inning, 9-8 game. Lescano, your Cleveland Indian All-Star. The pitch, 2-7s, a base hit into center field to tie it. Who was at second base? I forget. Schofield? No, Carew. Carew will run. 17, 18, 19. Lemon minus one arm to 18, and he scores. A two-run single for Lescano, scoring. Schofield, Carew, Merrickley comes back with a 10-9 lead. Three National League relievers cannot get the job done. Wow. And it'll be Petrocelli. Runner at first, two outs. Rico Petrocelli, 56 is strikeout off the Reed card. It's 10-9. Now the American League. Well, Baines is a two in right field, two in left field. I think I got defense everywhere, don't I? For the American League. Mercer's a two in center. Schofield's playing third. I could pull Willie Horton out of left field. Or move him to DH. Willie Horton will go to DH. Harold Baines is a better outfielder than, we'll take Epstein out. Yeah, Epstein got out anyway. All right. So the only guy left on the bench in the American League for pinch hitting if needed is Terry Francona, but Mattingly's a better first baseman. And Ken Sanders is now the incredible Milwaukee Brewer pitcher Ken Sanders from the worst team in baseball. Wow. Who would be getting the loss here in the National League? The two runs are off Camacho. So, yeah, Lefferts. So the San Diego, the worst team in the National League, Lefferts, his run would give him the loss if it's ended this way. Sanders, oh boy, would get the win. So it's Dave Rigetti in the eighth inning. The American League now, they have four closers to bring in a 10-9 game. Oh my goodness. So in the leadoff spot, Chet Lemon, who replaced Willie Davis, leads it off. Chet Lemon, 49 off Rigetti is a walk. All right, here's Wes Parker from the Dodgers. The pitch, 2-9, short B, fielder's choice. Wes Parker gets a fielder's choice. It'll be Claude L. Washington now is your batter with a runner at first. He's left-handed, so Rigetti will pitch to him. Claude L. Washington, the pitch, 1-8 is a strikeout. And with two outs, filling in for Johnny Bench is Joe Torre. Yeah, Brigetti will pitch to him. We have Tatum, Marone, and Grant are ready to go. I don't know. I'd bring it. You got a righty, four righties. Who's left on the bench for the National League? Rico Cardi is the only guy left on the bench who's right-handed. So I'm taking Brigetti out. Nothing but righties left. So Brigetti goes two-thirds of an inning. He can't lose. Tatum, Marone, and Grant responsible for the final four outs. So here's Ken Tatum. Ken Tatum's card in the eighth inning. And he'll face Joe Torre. Joe Torre, the tie run at first base. The pitch to Joe Torre. 45 is a walk. Torre walks. Two on, two outs. Jack Clark. He's played the whole game. Or we could pinch hit Rico Cardi for him. That would be the ultimate. They have the same card. You know, they both have the same 1-5-10 card. So that's what they're going to do because Rico Cardi is the last guy on the bench. So Rico Suave Cardi. Yeah. So the 320 hitting Clark will leave. The 342 hitting Rico Cardi comes in for Clark. Oh my goodness. Two on, two outs in the eighth inning. The pitch to Rico Cardi. 68 is a pop to first base. Tough break for the National League there. We'll go to the ninth. It's Mattingly, Pina, and Mercer. And I'm just going to go to Franco for the rest of the millennia here. It's John Franco will pitch till Wednesday. Here we go. Franco in the ninth. Terry Francona hasn't played yet. He's the only guy not to play. So, I hope it doesn't come down to defense and being a 2-10. So, Terry Francona will bat for Don Mattingly here to get every player in the game. So, Terry Francona is a 2-10, replacing Mattingly, who's a 1-6 at first base. Francona leads off the inning. 1-4, Brown's the second. It helps with these guys that have pretty much identical cards. And it's Tony Pena. Tony Pena, 58, is a strikeout. And with two outs, it's all up to Bobby Mercer. 37 is a K. Bottom of the ninth. Oh, what a thriller. You got Parrish, Beckert, Stone, Hansen. I think you have Tatum against the two righties. For Stone, they'll go with Lou Marone and then Mudcat Grant for the righties after that. So here we go in the ninth of a 10-9 game. Larry Parrish has started the whole thing. Leading RBI guy in the National League, Larry Parrish. The pitch, 58, skies the left field. Ken Tatum. And now you got Glenn Beckert. He hit 342. in 1971 for the Cubs. Glenn Beckert, first at bat. 46 is a walk off of Tatum, and that's the tie run. He's a good base runner, not a good base stealer. So, Tatum leaves. He got two outs. I never thought this game would be this crooked score. So that's like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 8 1/3. So we need two more outs. It'll be Lou Marone. We talk long and lovingly about this guy who just suddenly appeared in Seattle and went to the All-Star game as a Seattle Mariner representative in back-to-back years. He comes on in the ninth. Beckert is 1 of 15. He'll face Jeff Stone. The pitch to Jeff Stone. 1-7 against the lefty. I don't believe it. You got to look at the card to see it. Jeff Stone, triple 1 of 17. Look at the scoreboard, though. A 20. He missed the triple 1 of 17. He does not tie the game. It's a single for Stone. You got runners on the corners with one out. And it's Hanson, Lemon, Parker, Claudel. What do you do here? What a horrible bit of everything. Let me look at Mudcat Grant. You know what? Hanson gets more hits off of righties. He walks against lefties. So Marone will pitch. You have runners on the corners. You're going to go up and hold. Stone's not going to try and steal off of the -3 arm. It's Ron Hanson. Runners on the corners, one out off of Marone. The pitch. Ron Hanson. 42 of the infield up is the sac fly to center field. We knew this was going to happen, and we have a tie game. We have no pitchers left. That scores Beckert, and it's 10-10. And with two outs and a man at first, it's Chet Lemon. I got to save a pitcher. Chet Lemon. A 1-5 would end the All-Star game with a home run. The pitch to Chet Lemon. 53, rolls to first. And we've got extra innings. It's 10-10. I guess I picked a pretty good bunch of players since it's completely tied. 10-10. And it's all John Franco for the National League the rest of the way. And it's going to be Lou Marone and then Mudcat Grant after him. Both benches have been emptied. We have all the reserves are in here. So in the top of the 10th, it'll be Dick Schofield again, who's at the top of the lineup where Tovar used to be. Schofield, 2-6, is a bouncer to short. Carew, he's played the whole game. 47 is a base hit. Willie Horton, who's in the game at DH now. Willie Horton, 57 is a K. Willie Horton. And with two outs, Harold Baines, his first at bat. This is Harold Baines. Inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2020. And here he is in the top of the 10th inning. 68, skies the left field off of Franco. My goodness. Bottom of the 11th, Lou Marone. It'll be Wes Parker in the bottom of the 11th inning, leading it off. 2-8, grounds to second. Claudel Washington, a left-hander. 57 is a K. And Joe Torre is the batter. Joe Torre off the bench. 54, pops the third. Where was that last inning, Marone? Now we get a 3-up, a 3-down inning after all this mischief. We are in the 11th inning. Third inning for Franco. Ready to break. Here's Sixto Lescano. This is his third plate appearance. He's got a double and a two-run single. 1-4, bounces a short. Rico Petroselli. 4-10, bounces to short. Who's playing short? Hanson, he's horrible. He's a 40-14. But that time he made the play. My goodness, two outs. And it's Francona in the Mattingly spot. 1-6. That's going to be double 1-12. That's a double, a two-out double for Francona. He's the lead run. And it's Tony Pena. Tony Pena. 54, Pena, third X. Oh, this is going to come down to Larry Parrish. He's a four. What is he? His defensive third? Larry Parrish, where are you? He's a 4-14 at third base. He's a 40, makes the play. Oh my goodness. The inning is over. That's three innings for Franco. Let me just make sure I get the numbers here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Bottom 11th inning. And for Marone, this is two-thirds. He's pitched five-thirds. We go to the bottom of the 11th inning. He's pitched an inning and two-thirds. Lou Marone. And it'll be Rico Carty leading it off. Carty, 5-10 off Marone. Catcher's card. Pena is very good. He's a 1-E-something. 1-E-2. And he makes the play. Wow. Hope you're all still awake here. This has been a craziest All-Star game I can ever imagine. Larry Parrish. 35, double to right field. The National League has the winning run at second base. And it's Glenn Beckert. And then Jeff Stone after him. This guy's not broken yet. I got to save Mudcat Grant for if they win this game or they get the lead in the top of the inning. Only if Marone breaks. So here's Beckert. I really don't want to walk him. So with one out, it's Glenn Beckert. 32, fouls to the catcher. And with two outs, here's Mr. Mischief, Jeff Stone, who is triple 1-17 roll last time up, set up the National League tie. So Jeff Stone, he actually doesn't hit that great against lefties. And by the way, now I think about it, where is Carty playing? Oh yeah, Carty's playing left field. Oh boy, that's some bad defense. So it's Jeff Stone. 37 is a K. And Marone now has pitched 2-2/3. And Franco is in his fourth inning of relief because they got nobody else. Bobby Mercer leads off the 12th inning. 1-12, bounces to short. Now nobody's going to do any offense here. Dick Schofield back at the top of the order. 36 is a walk. He's an E-stealer. One on, one out, and it's Carew. One on, one out for Carew. 56 is a walk, and we haven't quite broken this guy yet. Two on, one out, one more base runner breaks Franco with nobody behind him. So the American League, this is it. You got to do it. Horton, two on, one out. Willie freaking Horton. 1-7, strikes out, misses a homer by one. And with two outs, here he is, Harold Baines. 5-10, struck him out. That's not a break, because he only put two men on in that inning. And John Franco, four innings of relief. American League blew that one. Unbelievable. Is it time just to go to Mudcat Grant? We got Hanson, Lemon. Yeah, Mudcat Grant is going to come on and pitch the 12th inning. So there you go. He's actually relief three. So a fresh Mudcat Grant is actually going to come in now because this game has just gone on too long. And we'll face Ron Hanson. The pitch to Hanson. 58. Sky's the center. Chet Lemon in the leadoff spot where Willie Davis would be. 49. Bounces to second. This is Carew, and Carew at second is a 3-27, and that is an out. And with two outs, it's Wes Parker. Parker, 1-8, that's a base hit. A two-out single for Wes Parker. And it's Claudel Washington. Winning run at first base, Claudel Washington. The pitch, 58. That's a sky to center off of Grant's card. Buckle up, we'll go to the 13th inning. Franco, he can break this inning. 13th inning. It'll be Sixto Lezcano, who's 2-for-3. 66, flies left. Petrucelli, 65, short X. This is Hansen again. He's a 4E14 at short, and he makes the play. Jeez. Oh, we gotta put it there. That's right. And with two outs, it's Terry Francona. Have to move it over there. Francona, 66, is a fly to right. Unbelievable five innings for John Franco. Ridiculous. We're just gonna cancel the music the rest of the way. So Franco, we go to the bottom of the 13th, Mudcat Grant, and it's gonna be Joe Torre. In the bottom of the 13th inning, Joe Torre, 52, sky's the center. Rico Cardi, who's actually playing left field, 5'11", second X, and this is Carew with 327. Base hit off Carew, one out single for Cardi. Larry Parrish, 2-6, that's a 6-4-3 double play. Mudcat Grant gets through two innings. We go to the 14th inning here in the All-Star game, 10-10. Tony Pena will lead off in the 14th. Let's see here. There he is. 57 is a K. Bobby Mercer, 33, rolls to first. Dick Schofield, 5'10", catcher's card. The catcher is Torre, and he's a 3E8 at catcher. The inning's over. Schofield gets out. Unbelievable. There it is. Six innings for John Franco. Unbelievable. Jim Grant, his third inning of relief. Glenn Beckert. Beckert, 2-7, grounds the second. Where's all the offense go suddenly? Jeff Stone. 1-5, Jeff Stone, and there it is! Unbelievable! Gotta look at the card one more time. Homer, 1-7, fly ball to right, and the All-Star game's over. As of all people, Jeff Stone, he probably hit the pole, or maybe this is an inside-the-park home run. He gets a walk-off homer, with one out in the bottom of the 13th inning off of Mudcat Grant. Franco gets the winning. The win, he is, obviously, John Franco is the series MVP with six innings of relief. I don't even think John Franco could pitch six innings, or I don't even pitch three innings. But the All-Star game is over in 14 ridiculous innings. Final score, 11-10. John Franco with the win, and he is the MVP. Mudcat Grant gives up a homer off of Jeff Stone's card on a 1-5, roll of 1-7. He takes the loss, and that'll do it. We'll do the box score. I'll take a break. We'll come back and do the box score. Thank you all for checking this crazy game out. Okay, welcome back, baseball fans. Just a little post-game. Did the final incredible box score of this exhausting game. And there it is. John Franco, he pitched six innings. He gave up two hits and two walks. And these purple represents all the batters he got out. He only put two men on one of those six innings. Meanwhile, the American League, they just could not have any pitcher pitch well in this game. Every pitcher gave up hits and walks. And if you look at the number of hits, Carew was 3-for-6. Lezcano, well, it's 2-for-4 coming in off the bench. Jeff Stone should have been co-MVP
because he actually got the walk-off homer and he went 3-for-4, but I just thought what Franco did was even more astonishing. Holding a team that had scored 10 runs through 9 innings, holding them down for, you know, the last 8 innings, I should say. 10 runs in 8 innings for the American League. And then he shuts them down for the next 6 innings. So they scored 10 runs in 8 innings off of these 8 guys. And then John Franco slams the door for 6 innings. He led the National League in saves, and he helped Cincinnati Reds get first place. So it kind of makes some sense. So Jeff Stone is an honorary co-MVP, I suppose. That's been the crazy All-Star game. We'll see you again when the second half begins. Mm-hmm.